So, I saw this little checklist for medical students that was going around in my association, and I was like, oh, it feels like good content, and I'm going to be going through it, telling you the stories behind it, and like just answering it. The first thing they have here on the checklist is dated the BAMP site. So let me just give you, in case you don't know, like, just like how if you are from Nigeria, you're a Nigerian, medical students have their different associations, and like they call them by their association name. So yeah, BAMS, we're an association of medical students, and so we call ourselves BAMS site. Just kind of cool. So did they the BAMS site? Well, the answer is no. Or should I say almost? Well, the answer is no. Will I in future? I doubt. See, I don't know, Sha. But I've hot takes on all this, on all this relationship, dating life, and all. My sister even said on one of our videos,
advise you, relationships in university, let me use in percentiles, like, if there are 100% of relationships in your university, not up to 2% make it out of the university gate, and out of those 2% that make it out of the university gate, not up to 0.5% of them get married. So basically, it's a time waster.
I don't know how people do it, because like, I've dated someone before, and I don't know, there are just these little complexities in this whole relationship dating life thing. I've been reading relationship books, you know, to understand, and anytime I read a relationship book, it just gives me one reason not to date in school. Like, I can't even imagine dating someone in my class, even if, like, okay, yeah, there are fine girls around, but you know, like, if I'm dating someone in class, like, would the classroom still feel the same? I don't know. If someone should even write a book like how to date your classmate, I'm sure I'll buy that book. The guys doing it, for the people doing it, like, kudos to you. Dating a BAM site, never done that. Let's go, because there are many things on the list. I don't talk too much about relationship dating stuff, but when we need to do it, we'll do it. If you want me to do it, tell me. I'll give you my hot takes. So they've gone for a BAMS fund. I'm sure you must have seen my vlogs on it, video. So yeah, I was part of the people who organized the first one, and like, we held the second one, and I vlogged the experience. It was very nice, BAMS one day, very nice thing. It's very nice to see medical students always like trying to hang out and have fun, because to be sincere, medical school is not fun. You can decide to have fun in your own way, like, you can make you studying fun in your own way, but like, I don't know who makes studying fun. Gone for a practicals without lab coats. No, okay, if they mean the practical lab where the cadavers are, the cadaver lab, then no. But if they mean like physiology practical lab, or like when I was in biochemistry practical lab, yes, because like, I don't think I can go inside a cadaver room without for like to the cadaver room when we have practical, when bodies are out at the lab, but like, the stench is just going to stay on your clothes for don't do that. Don't try that at school, unless you are at home. But like, yeah, it's only in school where you can, except you keep dead bodies at home, which I don't know how you're doing that. But going for a class 1 hour late, ha. See, yeah, I might have gone for a class 1 hour late, but I doubt if I'll enter the class. Most of the time, if I go for a class and I'm late, I'll just go. As I'm walking past, I look at the class, look at people who are sitting, look inside the class, look at people who are sitting in front, and just keep on walking to another class and sit down in another class and read, so that after the class ends, I'll go and meet people who were in front, or who I saw maybe were interacting with the lecturer in one way or the other, and collect details from them. Because if you are late, I don't know, I don't want someone to mark my face as a late comer, even though people say better late than never, but I don't know, sometimes it does not apply. I mean, just skip the class, go and read your book somewhere, and come and collect details. That's smart working. Enter the class for cracking silly jokes. I'm always serious in class, so I don't think I crack silly jokes in class. So I don't know. I've never been sent out of class. Started reading for an in-course a week before. Yes, I have. Not like you should. but I don't advise anybody to do that. But I've done it back in like back in the days, my 200 level days, and also yeah, we had some in courses like when I was in that intercalated year, we had some in courses to rewrite because our scripts, our the exam we did magically disappeared, so we had to rewrite the exam again. And like they told us like a week before the exam, they just came and tell us like, oh, we can't find your scripts and your scores are missing, come and write exam. And we did what we could do. Let's write the exam like that. So that's one of the instances where I read for, and because, and the other ones are just me being on serious watching How I Met Your Mother when I was in 211 instead of me to be reading. And I noticed that in course is closed, do not set in course dates, and I'm gonna carry your book. I try to deceive myself trying to read. Oh god, those days. Being insulted by a lecturer. I don't take insults personally. I don't know. There's no insult that I think has hit me. I don't think I've been insulted by it. Even if I have, they didn't really hit me. So like, all those things. So moved wrong stuff in public. Remember, there was one time I forgot the question they asked. I don't know, I've forgotten, but there was a physiology class and I don't know, I was so sure of this answer. I was so sure, you know, when you see when you move wrong, so when you move first with confidence, like I was so confident. And lecturer, I just rose up my hand. People around me like, put down, because like it's not really about, like I was a backbencher, so they just tell you. And like the class where the hall where stay was a very large hall, and I just stood there and just there at the back, but that day I was just listening and he just said something that I think I knew, and I just rose up my hand and he just came closer and I said, he just removed his face and said, next, Abby. And that person, I was like, ha. Now me do myself. So that time, I think I had this rhythm as I'm going to accept like electoral points at me. But I'm working on that. I should start doing it again because like it's kind of active recall, gives you a good feedback on whether you know something or you don't. You know, that kind of stuff. Self-diagnose yourself. If you diagnose, where are you diagnose? Oh. In Nigeria, you are still going to take your anti-malaria drugs, you know the vibes. Okay, I'm just kidding. But I don't self-diagnose. Anytime I feel ill, I go to the clinic. Like, my parents have actually paid money to the clinic, so why not use that money? Why should I go and self-diagnose myself and still waste extra money buying the drugs when I can go to the clinic, reach, meet the right personnel, the right doctor that is there, and they would, you know, examine me and give me the right drugs that I need. Well, I think I forgot to introduce myself. Hey legends, welcome back to my channel. My name is Haremu Mike. If you are new here, consider subscribing because I'm about to reach 1k subscribers. I want to reach 1k subscribers, and if you are watching this after I have passed 1k subscribers, tell me, because we can never tell. Next, in written an abstract or off-point answer during steeplechase exams. Yes, now when you see everything looking pink on your histology slides, you just be writing what you want to do. You'll be right. Anything that comes, sometimes I don't know. Funny enough, I found out that my histology does not. My histology, like me interpreting those things, sometimes not wrong. Like I just think I'm like, oh, I think this thing is nisu body, right? Nisu body. Yeah, I think this is a neuron, right? Neuron. Yeah, and most of the time I used to be right in some weird way. I don't know where. I think because I used to look at pictures online, like look at pictures of slides almost every single. Every, like when we do the class, or like if I'm reading my histology, I browse YouTube and like browse Google and just take a look at pictures of slides under the microscope, and I think that's what really helps me for doing that. But like I just feel like I used to write some abstract stuff. Even sometimes when they pin some part of the body, I just write something. At first I feel it's related to one part, like I just write. I'm a funny boy, but well, steeplechase exams. Meetings. Cried before or during or after exams. Cried before. I don't think I've never reached a point where, okay, this exam during the MB, at the time where I was kind of almost I was panicky. I don't know what happened. I think that day I was just feeling, so I was just lying on my bed and I started panicky. Then I told a friend and she just reassured me that everything's going to be fine and I'll pass and all, and like I just calmed down. I was like, oh yeah, why am I even panicking? Like that was the only time I even panicked. Throughout, I hardly panicked for any exam. I'm really just very calm. Like it's just another think the truth is, I don't know, many people panic for exams because they feel they're going to fail, or maybe they don't know something. But the truth is, you don't know whether what you read is going to come out. So why, like, panic? Like, panicking does not solve any problems. To me, I don't know, it's just the way I am. I'm kind of like phlegmatic, some sort of way. I'm like, ever since secondary school, I'm just like, university, the same thing. And that trick I use for exams is that I think of exams like I'm playing a video game. I know it's weird because, like, it's something I learned from Ali Abdal. Like, just picture your exam, like, okay, in video games, there are things you have to do in order to, like, pass a stage. And that's the way I look at my exam. Okay, I've done these things, and so they will lead me to passing this stage. And if I don't do them right, it will be game over or like restart or something like that. That's how I just look at my exam in such a way. But I do everything I can to pass the stage at once, you know, that kind of thing. Field and in course. If I count the number of field in courses I have, I had. Dude, I went to med school with. I don't think I got proper orientation when I got into med school. I got the orientation that med school was hard. You would get your shoe size as your score. Everybody's going to have red marks. And like, I don't know, I just absorbed that information that, oh, med school is hard and all. And I never really gave it much thought to that. In my head, I was saying they are just saying it. But like, field in course hits me, because I think there was it general principle one anatomy in course, when it hits me, in my head I was like, that's how med school is going to be. And like, I'm not even really putting in much effort. Thank God that, you know, boys have changed, we've gotten better information now. I know that, see, there are people in med school that are going to med school and they don't feel any single course, like, throughout their stay in med school. And you can't be like them if you are just starting out. Even if you are still in med school, you can, like, boost, like, since when I got myself back, since I started, like, changed my mindset towards med school, changed how I was studying, changed, you know, the things I started doing in med school, like, I don't think I failed any in course. And even if I did, maybe it was a close, imagine me saying close fail, maybe like a 48, which you try, sha. If you look at the average score, sometimes you know say 48 not try. Even if you fail in an in course in medical school, know that it's not the end of life. Just try to notice where you, like, try to look for the loopholes where you missed it. Is it that you didn't start studying early, or like you didn't study a particular area, you didn't go for class, you didn't, all these kind of, there's some little loopholes that we normally have as students. Wait, is this recording? Yeah, like, I have students that we can easily plug in, like, if you really self-reflect and like know what you did wrong and like correct your mistakes. There's no big deal, everyone will make mistake, and like, you can easily bounce back. Don't allow the failure to get into you. Let it just stay around, you know. That was that we say all this, like, it's not the water outside the ship that makes it a sink, it's when the water starts getting into the sink. So like, even if you feel that inverse, don't like tell yourself I'm a failure or something like that. It's just an exam is not who you are. Your grades don't define who you are, but that doesn't mean you should not want to get good grades and do everything and study well so that you can pass your exams, you know. Laughed when you saw your exam question. Yes, I've laughed for a good reason when I saw some of my in courses, like when I saw the question, like, I didn't even whining me, I didn't joking, and I also laughed because, like, I was not expecting some things, like, you know, all this guy, you laugh, there's a positive laughter and there's negative laughter, and then you just like, and the positive laughter is like, huh, these people are kidding. So, you know, I've laughed, so that's all the things I've done. Not understood anything in the class. Oh my God, 211. I like referring back to my 211 because those days were tough on me. Like, I'll go for a class and I'll just notice I'm just staying in the class. The class was big, and most times when you come, nursing students have taken the front seat. So you end up staying like in the middle of the back. You know, either you not be hearing anything, or you get distracted, or even when you're paying attention, sometimes you're looking like, wait, did I miss a class before this class? I know that's how the lecturer just come in and start talking about something that is in the middle of the textbook when I've just read like the introductory part of this course, or something, of this course. It's just It was crazy. I think I was lagging behind in the way I used to study and all. But also when we're during the COVID-19 pandemic, when we're having neural anatomy classes, yeah, sometimes I'll be looking like, I'll just like, as the lecturer is explaining, I'll just misplace. I'll be like, ah, wait. I just blinked. Like, I just decided to look at my screen. Like, look at another scholar. I used to follow, like, with a textbook or something and see whether they are saying some similar things. I'll just, when I come back, I'll be like, ah, when did we get here? But after the class, you know, I'm just giving you advice. Not like me, I was doing it. After the class, you go on YouTube and, like, see, YouTube is a very great resource. Just type in whatever subject you're doing. There are many videos. You can watch like 10 videos at 2x speed and like get understanding of what you really missed in class and all those kind of things. Also ask like people who you feel understood the concept, or always ask your lecturer questions. Like, I need to work on all those things too, but yeah, one reason, always ask your lecturer questions. They are there to answer you. And even if they tell you your question is stupid or is foolish, or people laugh at your question, and if they don't answer you, Google is still there. YouTube is still there. There's someone that will explain it even better, more in depth than people around you on YouTube. You know, Ninja Ned guys and those Indian gurus, you know. Going to class without bath. Who goes to class without bathing? Like, what? What? Who does that? I mean, I don't know, but if I don't have my bath, I'm not leaving. I'm not going to class. We can not go sit down close. You're not going to sit down close to someone and they'll be like doing like this. I'm like, oh, if you spray the other hand, I don't know. I'll feel dirty still. I don't want to sit down close to anybody if I go out, like go to class without having my bath. But like, got asked if you are really a medical student. Yes, I got asked when I was in 200, when I, you know, entered the medical, like I was chilling with the big boys, doing stuff, going around school, you know. I was not like I was doing anything bad or wrong or anything, but like the way I used to like meet people and just interact with them at that point, because that's the point I started trying to push myself out of this introverted bubble where I just stay alone with myself and my book. So I was trying out, like, I was meeting people, I know I was meeting a lot of people, and the way I just talked to them, most of them, when they later asked me, what are you studying? Because I hardly used to talk about that at that point in time. But now most of the time when I come to somebody and ask somebody questions, it's always with studying first. But anyways, and they hear I'm a medical student, they're like, you don't look like one, or you don't sound like one, all these kind of things. I was like, it's not even shocking. Like someone that, like, I was in Austrian, so someone that I was with, like almost a session had gone by, it was close to the exam period, and she was moving towards my college to read, and I was going there to her, and I said, what are you going to my college to do? She now looked at me like, your college, kid, I thought you're in SMS. It's not like it's a bad thing, but if you know, you know. Slept throughout an importance class. There's some classes, especially during this COVID pandemic, that we're having classes online. There's sometimes that I'm just listening to the lecture, I just like sleep over those of, but I don't know, is there, every class is important, or almost every class is important. I just put almost, that almost has to be there. Giving up on an exam and sleep, no, I've not slept, I can't sleep in an exam, like, who am I, me, eh? Sleep, but there's sometimes I've given up a lot of times on exams, most of the time. So when I'm writing, I notice that my line of thought is like just dwindling, like I don't know what to write again, and I don't want to keep on repeating the nonsense I've written all over again. I don't, like, I beg you, what I've written, I think, is enough to fetch me some marks. I just close the paper, or like close the book, or turn to another and try to answer that question. It saves me sometimes, but sometimes it prevents me from like hitting, like getting higher scores, because I don't know. It's just one of those lackadaisical attitudes that I think I need to deal with very soon. But sometimes I don't be writing. See, what I'm writing is almost, it's to me, it's not making sense again. And I'm sure to the lecturer too, if they are reading my script, if they reach that point, they see. And if I continue writing, the next things are going to not add any mark to me most of the time. So I just like, I beg, I'm done, Jerry. Whatever I get. I don't try my best in my head. And just give up on the exam and be like, food, carry my scripts. And most of the time I don't sleep, I just end up still looking, hoping that God will inspire, the Holy Spirit will inspire something for me to write, especially when I don't know. Just tell me, so God, please send the angel, send the Holy Spirit to like whisper into my ear, and let me just write something that is going to make a lot of sense to whoever is going to mark my script. That's what I just do. The star, you know, Holy Spirit activates. Voted in a BAM selection. Ah, yes, I always vote. I'm like, you know, I'm a, what do they call it? I always vote. I like politics and sort of thing. No, I like, especially politics. I like politics. I don't know whether I like politics, but I like getting involved in trying to move an association forward or trying to move a group of people forward, that kind of thing. I like getting involved in it, sort of some way, you know, even if it's behind the scenes, in front of the scenes, anyone, I like getting involved. Because like, I feel the best way to find yourself is through service. Like this YouTube channel started because I became PRO for my association at some point in time. And like, because of the research I had to do, what a PRO had needed to get, what skills I needed to develop, and I was developing myself aside, because I didn't know anything about the post or anything. So the president, the vice president, they just pushed me and said, ah, you should go for this thing, and I went for it, and I think I did a pretty good job till like I resigned. So then lots of paid departmental duties. As I said, I like moving every association forward, and like paying your dues is important, because if money is not coming into an association, no work is going to be able to be done. So that's that. You see, I'm a good medical student, I'm a good member of the Bowen Association of Medical Students. I don't know whether you enjoyed this, but I'm sure you might have enjoyed it, you might have picked something out of it. And I'm telling you to remain legendary. Remember, our goal this January is to get to 1k subscribers. So share this to your medical school friends. If you found like a part insightful, I'm going to leave chapters down in the description box, and like you can just send a particular segment to someone that to encourage them or to make them laugh or something like that. You know, I know the vibe. Stay legendary. I see you later.